Diary of a Wimpy Kid, Cabin Fever. November. Saturday. Most people look forward to the holidays, but the stretch between Thanksgiving and Christmas just makes me a nervous wreck. If you made a mistake in the first even month of the year, no big deal. But if you do something wrong during the holiday season, you're going to pay for it. Maybe you wouldn't get more presents if you were to pinch your brother last week. It's too much pressure to be on your best behavior for a whole month. The most I can really handle is 6 or 7 days in a row. So if they move Thanksgiving to the week before Christmas, it would be fine, mate. Kids whose families didn't celebrate Christmas are lucky because they don't have to stress out whatever way they do something wrong at this time of year. In fact, I have a few friends in this category who I think act like little extra jockey around, not just because they can. Oops! The thing that really makes me nervous is this whole Santa issue. In fact, that you can see you when you're sleeping and knows when you're awake really keeps me out. So I've started wearing sweatpants to bed because I really don't instead of seeing my indie underwear. I'm not really convinced that Santa has the time to keep an eye and 24 hours a day anyway. I figure he can only check in each kid once or twice a year for a few seconds. So when, with my luck, that happens to me the most embarrassing moment. That's disgusting! If Santa really knows he sees everything you do, then I should be in the trouble. So when I write to him, I don't say what I want for Christmas and all that. I use my letters to paint myself in the best possible light. Dear Santa, I didn't draw a crab apple at Mrs. Taylor's head, even though it might have looked away from a distance. Sincerely, Greg Heffley. Then there's those naughty or nice lists they're always talking about. You hear about it, but you never actually get to see it. So it's up to grown-ups to tell you where you stand at any given moment. And something about that just doesn't seem right. If you help me with these groceries, I'll bet it will be just enough to make Santa's nice list. I kind of wonder how accurate the list really is, wouldn't we? There's a kid named Jess Bells who lives up the street from me. And if there's no anyone who deserves to be on the naughty list, it's him. But last year, he got a dress by for Christmas. So don't even ask me what Santa is thinking on that me. That one. It's not just Santa's I've got to worry about. Last year, when mom was going through some word boxes, she found a home medal for her school childhood. Mom said to tell this called Santa Scouts, and that is sharp is just watching how kids behave and then report back to Santa at the North Pole. Well, I'm not so fan of this idea. First of all, I think you have a right to privacy in your own well. And second, Santa Scouts leaves me the willies. I don't really buy the idea that it stores is feeding Santa information. But just in case, I try to be extra because whenever I'm in the same room as Santa Scouts. May I clear everyone's plates? Why, how thoughtful of you! But it probably doesn't matter anyway because my older brother Roderick is constantly feeding Santa Scouts bad information about me. I carefully took a $20 bill out of my mother's purse. Every morning when I wake up, Santa's house is a new place, and I was supposed to prove that he thrived on the North Pole overnight, but I'm starting to wonder if it's really Roderick who moves him. Scream! Sunday. Today we took all our Christmas decorations out of the storage room in the basement. We have boxes full of ornaments, and some of them were pretty old. There one with the picture of me and daughter taking a bath is a thing that really embarrassing. But mom don't let me draw without. We put off the tree in the living room and started Without his tongue and other men's sons, my little brother Manny was taking off a nest upstairs, and when he walks up and found out we were still creating the tree without him, he had a total meltdown. The reason Manny was so upset was because someone has hung his favorite ornaments. This candy cane really his legs. So Mom took it off the tree and handed it to Manny to hang up himself. But Manny wanted the ornaments to be the first ornament on the tree. So the man here had to tuck all the decorations down just so we could get it away. And that's the kind of thing that happens in my house every single day. Mom has started to use the treat of Santa's as a way of getting money to behave. But if here she is, and I don't think it's such a good strategy just for keeping things light, though, because the second Christmas is over. Mom doesn't have any leverage. Well, the Easter Bunny is going to be very disappointed if it was Monday. Right before Thanksgiving break, there was a contest at school to see who comes with the best anti-bullying slogan, and the grand prize was a pizza party for the winning team. Only you can stop bullying from a team of 2 or 5 people and come up with the best anti-bullying slogan, the winning team will get a pizza party at the cafeteria. Let's make bullying a success. Everyone wanted a pizza party, and people didn't guess what we had to do with win it. Two groups of girls in my grade came with the slogans that were really similar, and each group accused the other of stealing their idea. Bullies are meanies. The whole situation spun out of control, and eventually the vice principal had to step in to stop him from turning into a full-scale riot. One school only has a legitimate sibling disease anyway, and his name is Dennis Fruit. And with all the signs and posters everywhere, I'm pretty sure the message is getting through to him. The day before Thanksgiving, there was a big anti-bullying assembly, and everyone in the center room was looking at Dennis the whole time. I kind of felt sorry for him, so I tried to make him feel better. Even though Dennis is the only weird really in our school this year, we had a bunch of them last year. People were constantly getting picked at during recess, so the teachers set up a station on the playground where kids get pressed apart enough they needed to get the grown-ups' attention. Well, the tale of teacher station just ended up being a convenient place for the building to hang out to our next victims. The teacher says teasing comes trick. The teacher says teasing comes as a bullying too, but I don't think there's any way that's gonna put up a so sad. Kids are always calling each other names and that kind of thing at my school. In fact, one of the reasons I try to stay under the radar is because I don't want to end up getting struck at a nickname like Cody Johnson said. In kindergarten, Cody sat in Sam's dad's poop and recess, and ever since then people who called him Dookie. And I'm not just talking about the kids either. And I'm not just talking about the kids either. I'm talking about the teachers of Evan, the principal. Congratulations to Dookie Johnson for getting straight as in the third quarter. I'm telling you this, if I ever got a nickname like Lucky, I will move to a different town. But what it probably happens if the summer from my old schools have moved to my new town and the whole thing will just start back up again. Hey Dookie! The teachers always says their newest getting picked up, you should tell the others. I think that's a good idea. But it would work out so well, and I was getting bullied. There was the kid who lived in the neighborhood next to me, mine, and for some reasons, everyone called him Nasty Pants. Every time me and my friends Rolly went through Nasty Pants' friends' neighborhoods, he chased me with a stick. Rawr! The things that really stunk was that me and Rolly used to roost in the neighborhoods as a shortcut to school. She started stealing a to-go out of the way to avoid getting embarrassed by harassed by his nasty pants. We did exactly what the teachers was always telling us to do, and complained to the vice principal. But vice principal says since nasty pants didn't go to our school, there was nothing he could really do about it. After getting chased several times, I decided I have enough. So I had that about the situation. I was afraid Dad was gonna say I needed to tell Wendell and deal with the problem myself. But it surprised me. Dad said that he had problems with the bully in my age and he knew just what I was going through. Dad's bully was named Billy Staples. And Billy's favorite thing to be was pinning Pete's arms behind his back and hold it there until he cried. Yeah, squeal! And said that the kids in the neighborhood told the parents about Billy, and they also went to Billy's house to confront his mom and dad. Mr. Staples made Billy promise to never pick on everyone ever again, and dad said Billy burst in tears and might have even wet his pants. Well, after hearing the story, I don't think Billy Staples hadn't been any match for his nasty pants, but I thought that I liked the idea of the complaining to the police parents. I called him up early and told him to come over and clean his head, because we needed so much help as we could get. Then knocked on nasty pants' doors, and we waited for one of the parents to open it. Knock, knock, knock. But nasty pants himself came to the door and me and Rolly took off. Rah! I guess I shouldn't describe Nasty Pants to Dad because it took him a while to understand that the kids who come to the door was the one who was causing all the trouble. Dad walked to Mrs. Pants and she held said that son was only 5 that just gets a little out of sometimes. You smell like a dirty poo. Oh, this A-Holmes said was pretty mad at me for letting myself get bullied by a kid who was still in the kindergarten. But let me just say in the defense that if some kid is chasing you with a stick, you don't stop to ask him for it already.